I'm Dr. Steven Simper from Rocky Mountain Associated Physicians, and I've been asked to talk to you today about bariatric surgery or weight loss surgery. I think the first thing I want to do is share with you my philosophy about this course and about this video that we're making here, and that we are here to give you information that you can use to make an informed decision about what's best for you. We are not here to talk anybody into anything, but to give you information. And in that light, I would recommend you continue your search, continue to get as much information as you can so that you can really understand these operations and why they're important to you. The first thing I would recommend to you as well is ask you, why are you reviewing this presentation? All of you have a different reason. Sometimes it's a new child in the family, grandchild, new baby that you're trying to keep up with. Sometimes it's a new medical problem that has arisen or other issues. I think it's very important for you to ask yourself why. And then once you understand why you are so concerned about your weight, is share that with your family and friends. Oftentimes obesity is misunderstood, and many times friends and family have little understanding about how this disease affects you and affects you both personally and physically. In that light, you're not alone. Obesity is a huge medical problem, not just in the United States, not just in Utah, but worldwide. The World Health Organization now lists obesity as surpassing infectious disease as a major cause of death and disability worldwide. Over 15 million Americans qualify for this weight loss surgery, and yet only a small percentage of them get the surgery, and yet it's the most effective treatment for their disease. That's a different problem that we'll talk about a little bit later. But again, it's a very common problem, and unfortunately, it's growing with time. The first thing I'd like to go over is how we actually measure obesity. Here's a variety of ways of measuring obesity, but the most simple clinical tool we have is the body mass index. I don't think in terms of pounds anymore. I think in terms of body mass index. It's a whole lot different to be 6'6" and 300 pounds than 5'6" and 300 pounds. And the body mass index helps correlate your height and your weight. The exceptions to body mass index are usually very obvious and are actually quite few. And unfortunately, oftentimes patients who have an exception to it, for instance, Arnold Schwarzenegger, when he won Mr. Universe, had a body mass index of 33, which would have classified him as being obese. Obviously, he's not. But if you look at Arnold Schwarzenegger today, his body composition has changed, and I suspect that he would be at risk of having weight-related problems, even though he tries to stay fit and tries to exercise as well.